I've got my caffeine because I've got a lot of presents to deliver very soon here. I'm shedding.
It's come and gone, and we'll see how tonight goes. We've learned some new mistakes. I've got this snazzy scarf. I tell you, I feel very powerful tonight. My friends sent it back. Are you ready?
Cool.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Song, we do it faster. It's like, blah, 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 blah. I feel like a chihuahua up here. Like, how fast can I say this?
You look like a deer in the headlights a little bit.
It's because my mind, I'm getting old. My mind can't even think of those words that fast.
Higgins can always talk fast. Don't tell me
that. That's very fast. Okay.
Okay,
I'm just going
to
sip here. Okay, hold it.
Okay,
just
hold it
a minute. I'm following
Daniel now.
Daniel.
You know Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Vixen, Comet and Cupid and Donder and Blitzen, But do you recall the most famous reindeer of all?
Everybody!
Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose. And if you ever saw it, you would even say it roars. All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then all the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee, Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history. Foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight?
Okay, I'll quickly introduce my own family. I'm the middle child, so I'll just start. I am married to Mike for 38 years, and our children are Rachel O'Brien, she's down there somewhere. Okay, and she's married to Jonathan, who was sick tonight, so he had to stay home sadly. And then they have three little boys, Jameson, Caleb. Oh, sorry. And Patrick, who's the baby. Then our next one down is Sally, and she is married to Greg, and they are expecting their first baby in March. Yep. Okay, our next one is Daniel, and he has a Rudolph thing on. He is married to Lauren, and they have a little girl, Summer. And then the baby of the family is Janelle, and her boyfriend, John, brave John with the trees on his head. Okay. Hey, you want to see
first? Sure. Now, I'm Lila Nielsen, and my husband is Peter, and our oldest son is Jack, down on the far end holding little Elise, and his wife here, Laura, and his daughter, Audrey, that's by me, and then my daughter, Marisa, is married to Andy, and they're stationed, he's a ranger, and they're stationed in Georgia, and we just had a little grandchild named Abigail, and they would have loved to be here tonight, but he was in a special training for survival, so she was just home, so we couldn't afford two tickets, so she'll be here next year with bells on, I hope.
This is my wife, Diana, and her daughter, my stepdaughter, is somewhere in Sturgeon Bay, so I don't know for sure where she is. But anyway, thanks. Pretty soon we'll have to have like an hour of introductions alone before the song. The first set will be. Is that it?
I'm
Julian. Yeah. Anyway.
The most important.
Pardon? Yeah. Oh, yeah, well, I want to introduce the band in a minute.
Yes,
why don't you
we'll
hire
all
us
go up, off, and then they can see the band.
Thank you.
Okay, let's go. Okay, good job. Good job. Thank you.
So don't forget the band here. This is Miss Liz Lynn Gudmundsen on fiddle and mandolin tonight. Mr. Rich Higdon on upright bass. Mr. Pat Judy on percussion, and Jimmy Halron will be out. He was playing harmonica a minute ago, but he'll be back out. So.
Excellent. You can clap for him then.
Or no.
Where are you going?
And have yourself.
was a good rehearsal right there. Cool. You're welcome. Thanks.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be miles away. Here we are as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends to us, gather near to us once more. Through the years we all will be together, if the fates allow. Hang a shining star upon the highest bough, and have yourself a merry little Christmas together, if the fates allow. Hang a shining star upon the highest bough, and have yourself a merry little Christmas now.
GPS for my guitar playing. Be kind to me tonight now. Yeah.
Kind of like herding cats or catching squirrels, because you get a few of them and then the other one goes and. I have to go right here. There. Okay. All right. So here we go. We'll introduce with ages. Okay, Audrey. See, I only have boys, so I'm not. Yes, okay. Hi, Jameson.
Hi, Mom.
How old are you?
5.
Okay. And Summer?
How old are you,
say,
Summer?
Say hi.
Say hi.
Say hi.
How's your stomach?
There you go.
How old are you?
How old are you?
Say one.
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 Good job. One. Wait, bye-bye. What's your name?
Two.
No.
What's your
name? One. What's your name?
What?
No, what's your name?
Name.
Caleb. Say Caleb.
Audrey, come over by Grandma's.
Say
Caleb.
Two.
Okay. He's still in training. Okay. Yes. You want to do it again? Okay, what's your name? What's your name?
Caleb.
Good job. Good. Yeah. And how old are you?
4.
It's 2, okay. Okay, you're all done, okay? No, you're all done.
I'm 2. 2.
Yes, you're 2. Good. What's your name?
Elise Wow.
Yeah, oh, Elise? No, Wow. How, can you take your thing out of your mouth?
Careful, sweetie.
Elise, what is your, how old are you?
I'm Elise Wow.
Okay, good. All right, 2.
I was going to give it to them.
Okay, well, at least we just don't want to have it laying there.
Audrey Laura Nielsen.
Yes, Audrey Laura Nielsen. And how old are you?
3.
You're 3. Yeah. And are you in school now? Yes, she is. Jameson and her in the same school. Okay, so Jameson, can you show everyone what you have in your hand?
A harmonica.
Yes, show them how it shines. Good. And tell us about it. Okay.
Jim.
Yes, what did he say to you?
Take care of it.
Yeah, he did. And where do you keep your harmonica?
In places where my brother can't get it.
Brother finds it. Okay, Jameson, and you and Caleb wrote a little song or have a little song you want to play on your harmonica. Caleb, raise up your harmonica.
Okay. Yep.
So can you play a little song and Caleb will play one too? Now, Jameson, you wanted to play Jingle Bells?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Okay, so now hold it up there. You ready? Okay, Jameson's gonna play Jingle Bells.
You guys are so malleable, yes.
Take the mic in a minute.
Okay, everyone's going to sing now. Here we go.
Take the mic right into the mic.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle bells.
Who's going to play? But you got to sing right in it.
We're Jim over here. Here we go.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey! Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a white horse open sleigh. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
They need a little fill-in because those two that were up here have to get some costumes on. So I thought I'd just ask a question. Does any of you ever seen Santa? Well, you know, if you haven't seen him, how do you know he's a man? You know, I'm not so sure, but I can prove that he's a man, because there's no way that a woman would wear that same costume every single Christmas. You know that? Yeah, there he goes. He's got that one. I think they're not quite ready yet. Maybe I'll ask some more. But being Swedish, I checked a number of things out, and it, to tell the truth, if you're going to deliver a toy to all these girls in the whole world, he would have to do 132,000 of those every second. And that's not even possible. But the only possible way that could happen is, being from Sweden, I know about reindeer. And reindeer, male deer, drop their antlers in September. Where the female, they don't drop their antlers till January or February. So what does that tell you about those reindeer? They're all females. They got weird names, but they have to be in order to truly be reindeer. So that answers how it's possible to deliver all those presents every second, because there's no way a man could find his way that fast. Isn't that right? So, well, we got some more, but we'll wait. Hopefully they're addressed now.
Wouldn't it be nice to be there right now?
Mele Kalikimaka is the thing to say on a bright Hawaiian Christmas day. That's the island greeting that we send to you in a land where palm trees sway. Here we know that Christmas will be green and bright. Sun will shine by day and all the stars by night. Mele Kalikimaka is Hawaii's way to say Merry Christmas to you. Take it, ladies. Will be green and bright. Sun will shine by day and all the stars by night. Mele Kalikimaka is the wise way to say Merry Christmas to you.
Sing it if you know it.
Mele Kalikimaka is the thing to say on a bright Hawaiian Christmas day. Shine by day and all the stars by night.
any bad jokes like my brother-in-law. I don't know. I don't have any good ones either, though, is the problem.
No. Daniel said, I have to do the next four songs in my shorts and my t-shirt and my Hawaiian thing. So I'm going to tell a quick joke if I can remember it, because it's really written out, and so I probably can't. But I'll just make it up as I go along. Okay. This is a real story. It's a true story. Okay, and it happened up in Wilmer, Minnesota. And this man was driving. Nope, wait. This man's car broke down, and so the weather was really bad, and it was really raining hard, and so he was really frustrated, and he was hitchhiking, and he was so cold, and it was raining, and all of a sudden, and this is a true story, I think I said that, I'll just say it again.
You did.
Okay, and so then, out of the darkness, this car came along the road, and it was going really slowly, and he tried to wave him down, and it just came up to him, and then just kind of stopped, and so he just jumped in the car to get out of the cold rain. So then the car just kept moving along, and then he realized that there was nobody at the wheel. And so he was really scared, but since the car was moving, he didn't dare jump out of the car. So then a sharp curve was coming up ahead, and he thought, I'm going to die. And he's saying, oh, Lord, please take care of me, because I'm going to die. And all of a sudden, his hand just, like, out of nowhere, came in the window and turned the wheel, and it just kept right on going, and the shadowy hand just disappeared, and he just kept riding, praying along, and another curb, and this happened like six times, and then just when he thought they were going to go in the ditch, this hand would come in to the window and guide it around the curb, and then it would just disappear, and finally he was just so scared, he just took his chances, and he jumped out of the car, and he ran into Wilmer, Minnesota, where this happened, and he went into a bar, and he said, give me two double shots. That's liquor. I'm not sure because I'm not a double shotter. But anyway, he took these two double shots and he told the story of what had happened. The people all listened because they realized he wasn't drunk and that this really wasn't. So they got goose pimples and everybody was just really, and they sat there and they thought, wow, this really happened. We called the newspaper and they were sitting there and all of a sudden the door opened in the bar and in came these two guys, and the one man said to the other man, well, Ole, there's that idiot that jumped into our car when we were pushing it in the rain.
Just need my baby's arms wound around me tight. Oh Santa, hear my plea. Santa, bring my baby back to me. Well, the Christmas tree is ready, the candles all aglow. But with my baby far away, what good is mistletoe? Oh Santa, hear my plea. Santa, bring my baby back to me. Oh, please make the reindeer hurry, the time is drawing near. It sure won't feel like Christmas time unless my baby's here. So don't fill my sock with candy, no bright and shiny toys. If you want to make me happy, you want to fill my heart with joy. Well, Santa, hear my plea. Santa, bring my baby back to me. Oh, please make those reindeer hurry, the time is drawing near. It sure won't feel like Christmas time unless my baby's here. So don't fill my sock with candy or bright and shiny toys. If you wanna make me happy, wanna fill my heart with joy. Well, Santa, hear my plea. Santa, bring my baby back to me. Santa, bring my baby back to me. Santa, bring my baby back to me. Santa, bring my baby back.
These children now, it's a riot, and I mean, they're just like crazy back there. They're all excited.
I think they're wonderful.
They're not
Violet.
Crazy. Wrong mic.
Must be the
they're
gene
not
pool.
Crazy. My grandchildren are crazy. We won't mention anybody else's grandchildren, but mine are not crazy.
Oh, wait, now, you shouldn't blame people for things, because... Because Adam blamed Eve, right?
Yep.
And then Eve blamed the snake, but the snake didn't have a leg to stand on. Right?
She wrote down C here.
Okay. I wrote C down.
But it's B though, right?
We don't know.
If you have a pen, we can pencil, we'll change it.
It's like in B. Okay, 1 second.
I think it's B, Julian. You have a big C on yours over there. You're the only one. We all have B's on
ours.
Well,
we'll just start over.
That's your own. I'm going to tune.
Oh, man.
1, 2, 3, 4.
There's a wondrous sight and a joyful sound every Christmas Eve in a western town. Gather up the kids, all the friends and family, 'cause the holly's hung and the candles bright, tuning up the fiddle on a moonlit night. Roll back the rug so we can two-step round the Christmas tree. There's a jolly man in a bright red suit. Did you ever see a Santa in cowboy boots? Twirling across the floor, birds are jingling merrily. As they sing those carols soft and low, I'll be shouting out Cotton Eye Joe. Roll back the rug so we can two-step round the Christmas tree. Wait beneath the mistletoe, you'll never get a kiss. I never move that slow, there's too much I could miss. 'Cause the western girl can't be still, and a silent night is not for me. Roll back the rug so we can two-step round. Gonna be ready when Santa comes, but I'm gonna be dancing till he does. Roll back the rug so we can two-step round the Christmas tree. Wait beneath the mistletoe, you'll never get a kiss. I never move that slow, there's too much I could miss. 'Cause the western girl can't be still, and the silent night is not for me. Roll back the rug so we can two-step round.
I know a lot of you, I bet you do two-step. I remember mom and dad two-stepping, and it's just beautiful when people do it right. They don't dance like that anymore. It's lovely.
Can you all dance ugly?
You still dance nicely.
You said nobody dances like that.
Well, just younger
dancers. Yeah, all you young people dance ugly.
Hey, Lila, how do you tie this thing? I've never done it.
I don't know how to help you on this.
Okay, there we go.
There is no way to make this manly right now.
I bet there's hard. Pretty rough here. There's probably no men out here that can tie these things backwards. You ever try that?
Okay, we ready?
Yeah, we're ready.
We're ready.
Okay, one, two, okay. One, two, one, two.
Sure do like those Christmas cookies, sugar. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. The ones that look like Santa Claus, Christmas trees and bells and stars. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe.
Now Christmas cookies are a special treat. The more she bakes and the more I eat. And sometimes I can't get myself to stop. Sometimes she'll wait till I'm asleep, and she'll take the ones that I didn't eat and put those little sprinkly things on top.
I sure do like those Christmas cookies, sugar. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. The ones that look like Santa Claus, Christmas trees and bells and stars. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe.
Sprinkly things just make things worse, cause it makes them taste better than they did at first, and they're absolutely impossible to resist. Some disappear to who knows where, but I make sure that I get my share, and those kids just stand there waiting for the ones that I miss.
I sure do like those Christmas cookies, sugar. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. Ones that look like Santa Claus, Christmas trees, bells, and stars. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe.
Now there's a benefit to all of this that you might have quite overlooked or missed. So now let me tell you the best part of it all. Every time she sticks another batch in the oven, there's 15 minutes for some kissing and a hugging. And that's why I eat Christmas cookies all year long.
I sure do like those Christmas cookies, sugar. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. The ones that look like Santa Claus, Christmas trees, bells, and stars. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe.
One more time, we'll go again.
I sure do like those Christmas cookies, sugar. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe. The ones that look like Santa Claus, Christmas trees, bells, and stars. I sure do like those Christmas cookies, babe.
Isn't that fun? Ooh, try to get this high. This is called Listen to the Angels.
Is that right?
No.
No.
Whatever you want to believe. Oh, that's okay.
I believe. What is that out of? Oh, I think that's out of Peter Pan, maybe.
That's where you live right now.
I think it's a Christmas carol. Grab the mic.
I believe, I think it's Scrooge. My students are doing that at my house, no less, next week. So
I love my version better. I like the idea of Peter Pan better. Relatively. Okay, I'm thinking. Okay, I am dangerous.
You'll never be ready.
I'm not.
Letters?
Okay.
What?
Okay.
No, that's not what we never done. Okay. So we can do whatever you want.
Okay.
Okay, you ready?
We're ready, okay. Freddy.
City sidewalks, busy sidewalks, dressed in holiday style. In the air there's a feeling of Christmas. Children laughing, people passing, meeting smile after smile. And on every street corner you hear silver bells. Treasures. Hear the snow crunch, see the kids bunch. This is Santa's big scene. And above all this bustle, you'll hear silver bells.
Have a good trip.
Okay, you gotta wait a second.
Okay. There's one common thing within Christmas, and that's expressions of love. And so we thought we'd add a song about love and all the different aspects of it, how it works together. So I know at Christmas time, expressions of that can mean a lot of different things, a lot of different people. And so this covers a lot of ground.
Cover some more.
While he's tuning. Yeah. Yeah. Well, let's see. What can we think?
Yeah, okay.
Let's see. Driving up here, we
saw...
serious
to say.
We saw a bumper sticker.
Yeah?
Yeah, it said, honk if you love Jesus. And then it says, text if you want to meet him. Okay, Julian.
That's funny, huh?
Yeah, well, that's good. So, there's a pastor sitting right here. I bet tomorrow morning this message you'll use that.
Perhaps love is like a resting place, a shelter from the storm. It exists to give you comfort, it's there to keep you warm. In those times of trouble, when you are most alone, The memory of love will bring you home. Perhaps love is like a window, perhaps an open door. It invites you to come closer, it wants to show you more. And even if you lose yourself and don't know what to do, the memory of love will see you through. Love to some, it's like a cloud, to some as strong as steel. For some, a way of living, for some, a way to feel. Some say love, it's holding on, some say letting go. Some say love, it's everything, some say they don't know. Perhaps love is like the ocean, full of conflict, full of pain. Like a fire when it's cold outside, thunder when it rains. If I should live forever and all my dreams come true, my memory of love will be of you. Some say love, it's everything, some say they don't know. Perhaps love is like the mountains, full of conflict, full of pain. Like a fire when it's cold outside, thunder when it rains. If I should live forever and all my dreams come true, my memory of love will be of my memory of love will be of you.
Mr. Jimmy Halron, Jim to the stage, please.
Well, that's the way it goes.
There you are.
He just wanted to be big, didn't he? He just wanted to hear his name over the speaker, I bet. That's
okay, he's got to go and get an A.
What did he walk all the way to the stage for without his... How are things in Nashville? My niece Nellie is living in Nashville. She's been cutting some demos and
definitely
writing.
Warmer.
Yeah.
It's warmer. It's different. It's fun. What? Yeah, I wish. You should go back there. It's even colder. So it's fun though. I really like it.
Do you have can you give him a little drawl?
Hey.
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 Hey. And watch, it's an F.
Is there an intro on this?
Jimmy has Jim.
I hope not. What do we do for
hey, Lynn.
Okay. I'll just do like part of a verse.
sorry. Not an A.
We're gonna listen to the other angels. It's the song called "Listen to the Angels." Kiwi, gotta do it. Who do you say wrote this, Rich? Leanne and something? Or?
Now I'm blanking. Niels and Leander. They're from the Twin Cities.
It's just gonna do what it wants to do.
They told you he was a poor boy, would you come? If they told you he was a poor boy, would you come? If they looked you in the eye and they said, do not fear, he is the one. If they told you he was a poor boy, would you come? Thank you.
something like that. Thanks much.
We get to get off now. Thanks.
We're gonna hop off. Thank you much. We just want to say a quick thing. We're gonna do one more song, take a short break. Want to thank Mr. Mark Thede up running the sound and his patience for all the chaos and chords and stuff here. Please give him a hand, Mr. Mark Thede. So I want to thank Third Avenue Playhouse. Thanks.
Whoops. Oh yeah. Oh, wait. That's right. Thank you so much, Rich. You the man. Got one more thing here. You can stay out and sing. Let's see. Okay.
You're gonna stand there just for a second, look really pretty like you do. And okay. Yeah.
Woo wee!
What's happening there, girlfriend? You are built for deep snow.
Hey.
Absolutely. Okay. We are celebrating Mr. Rick Cohn's 65th birthday tonight. I'm not sure where he is in the crowd, but we have to sing happy birthday for him, Mr. Rick Cohn. Just happy birthday, Rick. He'll know.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Ricky. Happy birthday to you.
That's from your lovely wife, Linda. Thanks much.
Not you. Oh, sorry.
Sorry,
it worked. What are you doing?
You were supposed to be feeding him.
I am feeding him. He's just, I'm only a fig.
I know.
I'm a figment of your imagination. I'm an angel.
Oh, good.
We always, every year, we want to acknowledge our veterans.
Oh,
and usually when we do this, Daniel will come out and wear a uniform from somebody. But this year, Sally's husband, Greg, was a combat medic in Iraq. And he was going to wear his Class A's, and they were going to dance. Now he's stationed in Nashville, and he does something with, biological, chemical, and something else, warfare. It's a very exclusively trained something. I should know this.
Big suits, the big suits with the masks, and goes out and tests, builds things.
But anyway, it's with the Army.
Fluid.
And Sal would know what it is. Whose grandchild is so noisy? Okay, but they were going to dance, but he forgot his Class A's, and so we'll do it next year. But we would like any of our veterans, whether you are serving now or if you've served in the past, we would like you to stand because we really appreciate you and we want to honor you. So we would like you to stand, please. And I don't know if we can put the house lights up a little so we could see them.
Greg's brother.
Thank you. I know that Greg's mom and his dad and his brother and Greg have all been in the service. So we just thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Home for Christmas, you can count on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents neath the tree. Christmas Eve will find me where the love light gleams. Oh, I'll be home for Christmas if only in my dreams. on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents neath a tree. Oh, Christmas Eve will find you now, where the love light gleams. I'll be home for Christmas, if only in my dreams. Mom.